Hi, I'm George Pearson, and I'll be showing you how to convert a Minecraft 1.14 texture pack into a Minecraft 1.15 texture pack. Now, if you like this video, make sure you hit that like button. Don't forget to click on share and also subscribe. I do a bunch of videos every single week, and you can find out more about that on my channel. Okay, let's get to it. Minecraft just announced the release of Minecraft 1.15 pre-release 1, which means it's almost ready for full release. And right down here, they said that December 10th will be the full release. So we're almost there already. But if you want to get a jump start on that, you may want to update your texture packs, the ones that you've built in 1.14. And I'll show you how to do that. Now, the reason why I need to adjust those is that if we scroll down here just a little bit on the updates, right here, they said they have updates to the resource pack format. Now, I haven't really found much that's changed, but a couple of things you will have to take care of. Okay, let's see what you need to do to update your texture pack. Let's just get that out of the way. There we go. First off, go to the Minecraft launcher right here, and then make sure that you have already installed and run at least one time the latest snapshot. So go up to installations and make sure that snapshots is checked right here. You then should see latest snapshot, and it should say right there 1.15 pre-1. There it is. And then just click on play. Now you have to have played this once, because the first time you play this, Minecraft is going to download the files onto your computer. So this is the part that downloads the 1.15 for you. Let's go ahead and click on play. We have to go into play anyway, so we'll just launch this up. And there we go. Let's go into single player. Now I have a couple of games going. Let's click on that one. I'll launch this bees one. And I want to show you the texture packs that haven't been converted yet. Let's go to the escape button right here. Let's just maximize that. There we go. Go into options, go into resource packs. And right there, there are a couple of my texture packs. See, they're bright red. That means these will not work right now on this system. Here's one that I've converted over here and is working just fine. These will not work. So we need to fix that. Now the first thing you need to do is you need to download the new jar file from Minecraft. This again is also why we had to run 1.15 pre-1 first, because that's going to download the files. We can then get to those files. Okay, click on open resource pack folder right here. It takes you into app data roaming resource packs. So back up one step. You should be in roaming now. And scroll to the top. Most of the resource packs are way down here. Scroll to the top, there's your Minecraft folder right there. Ignore this one down here, that's a test folder that I had running the betas in, so ignore that one. What you want is the .minecraft folder. Let's go inside that, and here, scroll down to versions right there, open versions up, and in here, look for that 1.15 pre right there. Those are all the snapshots that came before this preview right here. Let's go ahead and go inside that one. And there's the jar file that you want, 1.15-pre-1. There it is. Okay, we need to copy this over onto our computer. Now I've made a separate folder here for my 1.15 experiments. That's right here. And all I did was I took this file and then right-click and drag it over here and choose copy here. Now I've already done that, so there's that file right here. So I've copied it from here over to here. We can now close this folder. Now we're done with that for the moment. Now in here you need to unarchive this, unzip this, and you can do that just by right-clicking. Now I use a program called 7-Zip, which is free online. I'll put a link for that on the download page for my Minecraft videos. And this does a great job. Just click on 7-Zip, and then right down here, extract files. You want this one, not extract here, you want just extract files. The reason for this choice is it will then make a folder right here with the same name as that jar file, so everything is in the folder. So I've gone ahead and I've unzipped that here. Other unzip programs will also work. Anything which will uncompress your file is fine. WinZip will work out just fine. You can use WinRAR to unzip this. Just want to get this unzipped just like that. Okay, so there it is. There's our unzipped file. Let's open this one up. And in here, the very top, there's the assets folder right here. Now the way I like to do this is I like to copy this out. So right click and choose copy. I'll go back here to my test folder and then right click and paste. I've already done that, and that's right there. So I've now copied this from this folder to here. And the reason why I'm copying this and not just working in the one in there is I want to have that one as a clean copy of the assets folder. In case I mess this up, I can always go back right there to the clean folder. So I always like to copy that. This makes it much, much easier. Okay, so we have our assets folder right here. Now you need to have your old zip file as well. I have one here, Mars Textures with Spacesuit. This is a 1.14 texture file. I'll just click into this. It'll double click right here. Now all I want here at the moment is the pack.mcmeta and the pack.png files out of my existing texture pack. So I just copied those, you know, just like that, and right click, copy. Then I went back one step here, back to my folder, and then right click and paste. I've already done that and they're right here. Okay, so now I have our assets folder and the pack.mcmeta file and our pack.png, which is just the icon file. That's just that icon right there. That's all that is. Now when we're here, we need to edit this file right there. So let's double click on this, open this up. You can use any editor you want for this. I just use Notepad. And right here it says pack format. This needs to say 5. It's going to say 4 if you're converting an earlier version. So make sure you change that to 5. That's the most important part here. Now this is anything you want it to say. This is just the description that comes in below the name. That's this bit right down here. That's the description. So anything you want to say, I'll leave mine at 1.14.1.15. And then you save that file. Okay. I've already done that, so I'll just click on Don't Save. There we go. So that's taken care of. We've changed the 4 to a 5 in here. Now we need to come up here and fix the assets. So let's open this one up. Put that right here. Open up Minecraft. And down here are your textures, right there. Open this one up. Now so far I've tested this in the blocks. I've tested the color map. And I've tested the entities. I'm sure everything else works basically the same, but I've tested those at this point. Let's just copy over our blocks first. I'm just going to open this one up. Here's our block files. Okay, I'll bring back up that folder up here, the base folder for this. So I have both of those folders open. There it is. Okay, let's go back then into my Mars Texture with Spacesuit file right here. Open that up. I'll open up the assets and Minecraft. And then come down to textures and into blocks. So this top one up here, this is the new assets folder that we're setting up. And then here is the existing version 1.14 assets folder. Now in here I have just a few that I've changed. I have my Photoshop files in here as well, but I want these ones here. This is my bamboo stock. I changed the color of that one. And I'll scroll down a little bit. And I changed the coarse dirt. There it is. And scroll down a little bit more in here. There's the coarse dirt. And regular dirt right there. Grass block side, I did that one. And a little bit further. It's an old castle door. That is the oak door right there, top and bottom. Did that. And come down, I did the sand right there. And then a few things down here, spruce door, top and bottom. And spruce leaves, and spruce log top. And stone, there it is. Okay, so that's everything I changed at the moment for my Mars texture pack. I'll now right click and drag this over this way and copy those into the new texture folder. Then I'll click on replace the files. And the reason why I'm copying these over and replacing them instead of just changing this file over to the new format is I don't know what else they've done on the resource packs. It says they changed formatting. I don't know what else they've done. So all you need to do is just copy your old textures over into the new assets folder and you should be fine. Okay, let's go up here to textures again. Now in entity right here, and then back here, and entity, this is the old one right here. And let's just change the view on this thing to a list. There it is. Now in here, I have my Steve file. This is Steve in a spacesuit. And over here, if I scroll down, there's Steve right there without the spacesuit. So again, I'll just take this, drag it over here, and copy that over, and then replace. That takes care of that one. Okay, so we're getting there. Now, the one thing that I found that didn't work for me over here was the color map. And there are two files. Let me just change the view on that to large icons. Then it'll bring this one up here. There we go. This normally is green, and I changed this to orange colors for my Mars grass look. So that one didn't work. I don't know why, but that one didn't work. So everything else did work just fine. Okay, let's now go back over here again, and I'll back up back into 1.15. And what I did here was I took the new version of that one file, that's the textures and in the color map, and that's right there. I took the new version of this file right here, I copied that out, put it right here, and then I changed the color. So that's all I did. Okay, now I can take this one and put this back into that new location. I'm just going to copy and paste on this one. Copy, and then back into Assets, and Minecraft, Textures, Color Map, and then let's paste, and replace. There it is. There's my new Mars coloration on that. Okay, so that's all taken care of very nicely. Now, I've also done sounds, and I've tested sounds as well. Let me go ahead and pull those up. There it is, my other resource packs. Now, here I have one for sounds. Let me just go inside of this one, and into the Assets, and Minecraft. And then right here, I have a folder for sounds that I made. You can look at my video on how to do sounds that explains how you do this. But this also works just fine, so let me copy that over. We're in Assets, let's just open this one up here, open up Minecraft. There we go, there's your textures right here. So in this location, just inside the Minecraft folder, I'll take the sounds and I'll copy that over, right click and copy, and there's the sounds. Okay, now we can go back out again to this location. We're done with this, I'll just get that out of the way. So I've now updated the textures in here. I've updated a few of those texture blocks. I've changed the Steve texture, and I've also added in those sounds as well. Now all we need to do is to re-zip this up. So let's click on this, hold the Control key down, click on our fixed pack.mcmeta. This one has a 5 in it, and my pack.png icon. There's the icon file right there. Right-click, and again I'll be using WinZip to zip this up. Add to Archive right there. Now if you're using a different program, make sure you go to the zip file format. So click on Archive. Up here, if you're in 7-zip, make sure that this archive format is set to zip. Right there, it's the bottom option, and it should say zip. Okay, let's just change this. I'm going to call this one Mars Textures. I like putting dashes in these. There you go, Mars Textures, and I like to number mine as well if I'm just playing around. Okay, there's the zip name. Choose OK. And we'll let this zip up into that new zip file. As soon as that's done, we then should be able to use this file, this new texture file, inside of 1.15, and we'll test it out right here as soon as the zipping is finished and make sure this whole thing is working properly. The three main things then is that I'm using the new 1.15 assets folder, and I'm using my old pack.mcmeta, but I changed the number from 4 to 5, and I'm using my existing pack.png. So, new assets, copy over your old textures into the new textures, and then these two files in Fixture MC Meta. Okay, that's all set to go. Let's go ahead and find that. That's right there, Mars Textures 1-zip. There it is. Okay, let's go back here to the game. Open resource folder. Let me just back up just a touch. There we are, right to this page, game menu, options, resource packs, open resource pack folder. There's the folder right here. We need to copy over our new files. Let me bring the other folder back up. There it is. And I'll right click and drag that over here. Copy here. Okay, there we go. I can now get this out of the way. That's out of the way. Click on Done. Click on Done again. Go back to Options again. Back to resource packs, and that should now be showing over here. Here it is. There's our Mars texture pack. Notice how it's no longer red. So this isn't red. It should work. Click on the move arrow right there. It should be at the top, and it is. That's our Mars textures 1-zip. Click on done. Let's load this in and make sure this has all properly worked for us. Click on done again. Back to game, and there we go. There's our nice Mars colors in there. So I've colorized the dirt here, which also colorizes the small plants. The sides of the dirt are colored. And if I change over here so we can see my spacesuit, I'm wearing my spacesuit. That worked out just fine as well. So there you go. That is how to convert a 1.14 texture pack into 1.15. Not that difficult. The main thing is changing that 4 to a 5 in pack.mc meta, and then copying all of your old textures from your old texture file over to the new texture assets folder. Now, if you like this, make sure you click that like button, and of course, click on subscribe and click on share. And don't forget to take a look at my channel. I have loads of videos over there. I do a bunch of videos every single week. So check out my channel to see what else I've been up to. And I'll see you next time.